I honestly have lost count of how many times I plan to go out and take photos of sunsets and sunrises. And I arrived to the place and nothing. It's just a very bland sky with no colors whatsoever. And that's the life of a landscape photographer. This can be super frustrating, especially if you're actually traveling. If you have a few days to be in a place to capture that image that you have been planning for such a long time, and the sky doesn't work, the gods of landscape photography don't look down on you and say, "There you go, son, you have those really beautiful colors that you need to make a very nice image." That happens. It is frustrating, but at the same time, it's what keeps me very motivated to go out to create more and more images. I'm always looking for those special moments, because when you do find that perfect sunset with the awesome foreground and beautiful clouds, super colorful, you create this very different appreciation for nature. Now, with the development of artificial intelligence, we're starting to see this new trend of creating composite images. And honestly, I think it's okay. I think it's fine. It's another tool, is the next step in photography. So I want to show you how you can swap the sky of this image using the sky of this image. It's a very easy process in Photoshop. So let's hop in Photoshop and see what I have to do. So this is the image that we're going to be working with. And by the way, if you want to follow along with me, you can go to my website, it's going to be in the description, and you can download those two images so you can actually do the same things that I'm doing here on my computer. Once you open your image, you're going to go to Edit and Sky Replacement. And that's it. It's this easy to create a sky replacement in Photoshop nowadays. The artificial intelligence behind this function is amazing and creates such a good result. Let me walk you through this menu here for the sky replacement. The first step we have is the sky. So you're gonna have to go through the collection here of skies and select which sky you wanna use in your image. And as you can see here, Photoshop provides you a library with a few different skies. So you're gonna have blue sky, spectacular sky, whatever that means, and sunsets. I have created a personal folder here, the task. I'm gonna delete this to teach you how you can create one folder in your library. So it's very easy. You're gonna have to press this folder button icon. You type a name. I'm gonna name test. And now we're gonna see the test folder here. I'm gonna import the sky into this folder. And the sky we're gonna use is the sky from this image here. So all I have to do is press open. And now the artificial intelligence is going through the image and deciding what is foreground and what is the sky. And it's doing this automatically. I don't have to create a mask. I don't have to do anything. Once the software does this, all you have to do is type a name for this. So it asks for the sky name, as you can see here. I'm gonna name test because I'm a super creative person. And now the software is gonna replace the sky with the sky from my test image. As you can see here, the result's really good, like straight away. Yes, I do realize that this is a very easy image for the computer to work with because the horizon is very straight and there is nothing there. There is no curves. It's very easy to create this mask. But often this software does a really good job in finding the sky and creating this mask. So now that you know how this sky tab works, let's move forward and see what these sliders here are gonna do to your image. So the first slider we have is Shift Edge. And all this slide is gonna do is review more sky from the targeted image. So the sky from the replacement sky, or gonna review less of it. So if I go to -100, we can see the sky that we are seeing right now in the image is the original sky. And if I go all the way to +100, all the sky is from the my targeted sky. Because the horizon is very straight, there is no curves, I'm gonna leave this at zero. It was really good, like spot on zero. I like this, how it looks like. So the next slider is the fade edge. The fade edge is how subtle the transition between the foreground and the sky is gonna look like. If I leave this to 100%, it's gonna be a very smooth transition between the foreground and the sky. And if I decrease this to zero, it's gonna be a very sharp edge between the foreground and the sky. In this case, I'm gonna leave this 100%, and that is how you can control the mask that is creating the blend between the foreground and the sky. So the second portion of this menu here is related with the brightness of the sky. If I want to create a very bright sky or like a little bit more dark sky, and the color temperature of the sky. I'm doing this to try to match the sky with my foreground. In this case, I think that by making the sky a little bit warmer, it is gonna be easier for me to match the sky and the foreground. So the last portion of this menu, it is related with the foreground adjustment. So you're gonna be able to adjust the lighting and the color of the foreground. And the first thing you have to decide is if you're gonna use multiply or screen mode for the blending mode. And don't get too caught up in this. Just remember that if you multiply, you're gonna make the light that is being selected dark. And if you use a screen, it's gonna be lighter. So let me show you how it works. If I have a screen and I increase this slider, you can see that this portion here, which is the transition between the foreground and the sky, gets lighter. If I switch this to multiply, it's gonna get darker. So you have to decide how you wanna make this transition. Do I wanna make this transition a little bit darker with more contrast, or wanna make this lighter with less contrast? In my case, I'm gonna use multiply, I'm gonna decrease a little bit in the multiply, and I quite like this way. And the last slider is very easy, is the color adjustment. And all we have to do here is try to match the color of my foreground with my sky. So let's play around with this slider and see if we can get a nice match between those two portions. And I think this looks good enough. And now all you have to do is press OK. After you press OK, Photoshop creates this layer saying sky replacement group. And inside of this, you're gonna have a few different layers. So you have the layer from the sky. And if I press a toggle on and off, you're gonna see that my sky is gonna change. And this layer, we can see that we have a layer mask. So it is actually hiding away all the foreground of this image. And then I have a few adjustment layers on top of it. So we have the sky temperature and we have the sky brightness. And on the bottom of this, we have the layers for the foreground. So those layers actually dictate the brightness and the color adjustments that we make for the foreground. And that's it. It's such an easy process. You just have to select two images and play around with the view sliders. Don't have to worry about learning about layer mask. Not that you shouldn't, you should definitely know about layer mask. Photoshop is an awesome tool for photography, editing, and everything. But you don't have to worry about it because Photoshop is gonna do everything for you. It's gonna detect the sky, it's gonna create the layer mask, it's gonna do all the adjustments to blend those two images well, it's gonna try to color correct, and it's gonna give you the best result that you can possibly get. Hopefully you liked this video. If you did, don't forget to give me the thumbs up, and I see you guys next week. Bye.